Hi folks, welcome back. I'm going to be doing a tutorial of how to get your Unity Vuforia application off your computer and onto an Android device. There's also a video that I've made previously for iOS devices. This is a much simpler video, and it's very easy to publish your applications from Unity to an Android device. Okay, so first getting started, I'm currently in a file that I've used before. It's our double astronaut file, but you can use this tutorial on any Vuforia tutorial that is currently working. You can publish that. You don't have to get to the double astronaut. You can do the original tutorial. You can do any of them, and it should work. Now, I'll also remind you, I'm on Unity 2021.3.5 F1, and I know that Vuforia and Unity can be buggy with each other. So if you run into problems, it might have to do with the version that you're running, and you should try running the same version that I'm running right now to try and get rid of any of those problems. So first things first, I've opened up my file. I'm going to make sure that it's working on my PC. So I just go ahead and hit play. That's going to run the program on the PC. It's going to use my webcam. And sure enough, it is still working. I've got my two astronauts, slightly different scales because I printed out my different icons, my image targets at different scales as well. Okay, so I know that it's working. And now that I know it's working, I go to File, Build Settings. Now, right now I'm in the double astronaut file, which is an evolution of my PC build, and this is going to be my Android build. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save this, and I'm going to save it with a new name. I always save in my scenes folder, and I'm going to call it Astronaut Android, just so that if I'm making any changes in here, if I run into any problems, I can go back to the version that I know was working. So in build settings, this needs to know which scene to build. And since this is a different file, we need to add open scenes. That is going to add the current file, which is the astronaut Android I just saved. And I'm going to remove by right-clicking the PC build so that it's not going to build that. In the future, you might be building multiple scenes and you'll be adding multiple scenes to this build list. But right now, we're just going to do this one. Okay. Now we need to go down to Android. We select Android and we right click, I go down here to the lower right and I say switch platform. And this is gonna take a little while, not too long, but I'll probably fast forward this for the video so you don't have to sit and wait. Oh wow, that was super fast for me. That might be because I've done this already on this machine recently. The first time you do it on your machine, it takes a little bit longer. So if your timeline takes a minute or two, don't be worried. Now, in the Android, there are a few player settings that we could manage, but right now, for this build, I'm just going to have you build it. So we go to build, and we want to save it somewhere. I always like to save it in my job directory. I typically go into the build folder, and then I am going to save it as, look at that, build Android. That's a great name. So I'm going to save it as build Android, and it's going to save as what's called an APK file. All right. I'm going to go ahead and do that. And now it's going to start building. I'm going to see some errors down here. The first one I'm going to see is minimum Android API level of 26 is required. I'm not worrying about that right now. I've done this multiple times. I'm going to tell you to just do the same, and most likely it will work. I will make a second longer video with some of the troubleshooting and get more in depth about the player settings. But I'm going to go ahead and let this build. Usually this takes about 10 minutes. So I'm going to step away and get a cup of coffee and fast forward it. Wow. It went fast on my machine today. Normally for you, the first time that you do it, it's going to be about a 10-minute build. So if you want to step away and get a cup of coffee while that's doing it, pause the video and come back when it's done. you should go right ahead and do that. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I am going to open up a file explorer, which is showing me the build folder, and right there, there's the Android APK. That is the file that we're going to run. It's also made a folder here called build Android backup this folder, but don't ship with your game. That's all the drivers and other things and like the packaging that it's made to make your application. So you can save that, but you don't want to be sending that. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to pull over another file explorer tab, and I have my Android device just plugged into my machine right here. And so all I need to do is go to that device, and I'm going to go to my downloads, and I'm just going to drop this APK file into my downloads folder. This is about a 70 megabyte file, so it's pretty sizable. It's too big to email, most likely, but if you want to Dropbox it or if you want to Google Drive it, that should also work if you aren't able to plug it into your machine like I'm able to do here. Okay. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to segue from my PC to my Android device and see how everything's working over there. Okay, here we go. I'm on my Android device. I'm going to go to my files and go to downloads. And there you can see my build android.apk. You know, probably if I was doing development for something other than this tutorial, I might have given it a better name than build Android so that I would remember when I install it and I open it in the future what it is. But now I'm just going to go ahead and click it, and it's going to start to install it. But it's going to be blocked for security reasons. So what I need to do is click settings, and I'm going to turn on install unknown apps for my files. And when I'm all done, I'm going to remember to go back and turn that off. And then it's going to ask if I want to install this app. I'm going to say install. It's going to say that it's blocked. I'm then going to hit more details and say install anyway. It's being blocked because it's not going through the proper channels to get certified. I'm not going to send it in for a security check. This is because I've made this, so I'm not worried about it. And then I'm going to say open. I will get a warning about my, or a question about my camera. I'm going to say allow SP2023 AR, which is the name of my application, to take pictures and record a video while using the app. And if you get a black screen, you might have forgotten to say yes to this. It's going to take a second, and then there we are. It should now be working. It's recognizing one of my image targets, and there we go. It's recognizing the other one. So I now have my Unity Vuforia application running on my Android tablet. This is much quicker than going through the steps for iOS. And so even though I am often using iOS devices, I do almost all of my testing on my Android device because it's a faster sequence. I can build and I can get feedback and I can see how it works on a tablet much, much quicker than if I'm trying to make it work on my iOS devices. Okay, let me know if you have problems. I am going to, again, do another video where we look a little more in depth at the player settings. We do some tweaks to it, and we understand a little bit more about all of those specifics of building Android applications from Unity and Vuforia for our AR applications. Thanks for joining.